Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning. Welcome to the Green Valley Parkinson's Support Group exercise class. Joining us for the first time online, welcome. You're going to need a straight back chair without arms, a pair of light hand weights, a tennis ball, a larger ball, and it's always good to have
water
when you're working out. Absolutely. We start out in warm-up position in the chair. We end in the chair for cool down, and in between those times we'll be standing. So have a seat. I'm going to turn this down. For the warm-up, I ask that you sit more forward in the chair than maybe you would like. Try not to use the back for support, your feet flat on the floor, your hands on your thighs. Take a deep breath through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Again. And let it out. Drop the chin to the chest. Pressing your shoulders down. Now look up and relax the jaw. The mouth opens. Center and ear to the shoulder. I don't hear anything, do you?
Creak.
Yeah. True. Drop that chin to the chest, and it's a slow circle. Both directions. Again, chin to the chest, raise it and look up. That mouth opens slightly and back to a neutral position. Turn to look over your shoulder and to the other side. Side to side, turning just the head and center. Nod up and down, up and down. Good. Roll the shoulders. And whatever you do, don't smile. Everyone's so serious. Up and down, up and down. Good. And one more. The arms now out, shoulders relaxed. Move your fingers, your thumb. And then extend those out, tapping each finger to the thumb. Good. Scratch. Good. Make a fist and squeeze. And out. One more time. Squeeze. And out. Circle. Isolating the wrist. Good. Let's go the other way. And we end up in that same position for some arm circles. Watch out. You two are awfully close. Good. Change direction. Super. Work those shoulders. Let's keep those arms overhead, reaching for the ceiling. One, and if you're
two,
at home, count with us. Look up.
Three,
and
four,
and one more.
Five, and
the arms return to the side. It's a flexed hand. Bring it to the shoulder. It's
one,
out, in,
two,
yeah.
Three, four, five.
And they come down. Placing one on the chair and one overhead for a side stretch. And now to the other side. Stretch. Cross them, twisting the torso. See something behind you? See if you can see it when you twist this side. Yeah, and there. The hands rest on the chair. Shifting the weight and the opposite hip is off the seat. And
two,
and
three,
and
four,
and
one more.
Five. We take it into a march. The arms moving, the knees lifting. Barefoot. Hi, Mary. Hi, Dave. Good. That is warm up. We come back to this position. Arms are dropped to the side. for some heel taps. That leg is out, it's a flexed foot. Good. Toes up. Last one. Good. And back into this position for rocking back and forth. Heels up, toes up. Good. Alternate. One up, one down. I have to think about that sometimes. I look at you for a cue. Yeah, back and forth, working ankles. And we stop in that same position. You've got plenty of room behind you, I hope. If you don't, you should have some room. You could actually lean forward and back and not use the chair for support. Reach down, please, and grab the weights. We're gonna start with a bicep curl. The fingers are wrapped, the elbows are tucked. And we're gonna look forward, lift it to the shoulder.
One, two,
and shout it out.
Three,
four,
five, six,
seven,
eight,
nine, ten. And come to rest, maybe a good stretch, a deeper breath in between those sets of 10 reps. So again, looking forward and not down, but out. Yeah, chin up, raise them.
One, two, three, four, five.
Good.
Six,
seven,
eight,
nine, ten. Dropping the arms to the outside of the chair legs, sitting tall, rotating the shoulders and arms and weights forward and then back, pinching the shoulder blades together, stretching the chest. And then they come to rest in that position again. Lift one, the elbow tucked to the back for a side stretch. And then to the other side. Fabulous. And there. I'm gonna put them on the floor. We'll pick them up after a stretch or two. So we're in a good position for balance, whether you're standing or sitting. But right now we're gonna bring it into a closed position. Maybe a little adjustment in the chair. Try to stay away from the back. The arms are crossed and the legs extend. The feet are off the floor. Flex
one,
and point.
Two.
You're right.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Good.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
We end in that flexed position. The heels together. Toes out.
One.
In.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Let's reverse
five,
it.
One, two, three,
four,
five.
Great job. And they come to rest, separating the feet, uncrossing the arms, and one leg out. So if we were here, you're just gonna slide the foot forward, trying to keep a straight leg, and also trying to keep that foot on the floor, working some flexibility in your ankle. So the hands are here, reaching up first and over as you let those arms travel down. Drop into the stretch. Drop your head, take a breath, and come up. Yeah, like you're gonna adjust your shoe. Sock, tie your shoe. Drop into it, and come up. Not you, Bruce. He doesn't have shoes on. And the other one straight out. The arms travel down, drop into the stretch, and come up, nice. And again, up and over, super. Always working within your range of flexibility, so just because somebody beside you is doing more or lifting more weight, doesn't matter. So work within your range. We're gonna take this in a wide position. Bless you. Wide position, shifting your weight, knees directly in line with your feet, but the arms are out and the fingers spread apart. Palms facing forward. Yeah, so palms up, palms forward, down, and back. Yeah, that's the only way they're gonna move. So right now, we're gonna place one on the inside for support, straight up with the other. We're gonna twist toward this arm in the air and reach for the ceiling. Your focus is on your fingers up there. The other hand is giving that leg some support. Good. Return to the center. Place the other one on the inside, straight up. Twist. Reach for it. Those clock arms, 12 and 6. Beautiful. And here, drop the arms and the feet walk in, pivoting on the heel and the ball of the foot back to a closed position. So feet together, your knees together, the arms crossed and a flat back. Looking forward, the knees open, and all that weight is on the outside of your foot. Do you feel that, Mary? Yeah. Do you feel it? Push. Yeah. And then come up. And the weight forward, rock. Oh yeah, nice job. And there, back to a very wide position. Toe touches. We're gonna go to the back side of the heel and each one gets a count. Two. I like that.
Three, four, five, six, seven,
good.
Eight,
nine, 10. Pivot again. Heel, toe, heel back into a starting position. Bless you. Back there. So shoulders, hips, knees, heels, they're pretty much in line. One weight, both hands. We're going to do an overhead extension. So the arms are raised overhead, the shoulders somewhat relaxed, the chin up, and the weight drops gently to the back. Extending the arms
One.
Overhead and down.
Two.
Good.
Three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine, 10.
Great job. Take a break, breathe and stretch. We've got one more set to do. And again, straight up, shoulders relax, the weight drops to the back, elbows, they're pointing upward, and it's
one, two,
good.
Three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
10. And down. Placing that one on the floor underneath the chair. We're gonna bring our knees up, but with a little help. So the fingers laced together, a knee that's up. Place it not on the knee, but below it as you bring this up and circle one. I always think
two,
of Fred when we do this.
Three,
four, five, go the other way.
Five,
four,
three,
two, one. Placing it down, the weight shifts slightly, and that's very different than leaning. So you just shift a little bit. And it's up high, circle one,
two,
three, good.
Four,
five, change it.
Five,
four,
three,
two,
one.
Putting it back into this place. The arms are dropped. Tall in the chair, a knee again is up, flex foot, extend it and point and flex.
Two, three,
four,
five,
six, good,
seven,
eight,
nine,
10. Good, placing it wide, shifting the weight, lift it, flex and point.
One, two,
good,
three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
excellent,
nine,
10.
I like that one. You're working on balance. You're working your hip, your knee, and your ankle as you bring that back and forth. So we're back into this position. Both weights, please. We're gonna do an overhead press. So it's here. Looking forward, lift them up.
One.
Two. We'll wait for you, Bob.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six. Good.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
10. Take a break and breathe. Use that time. Breathe and stretch a little. Yeah. And again, sit tall, focus, bring it here and straight up.
One.
Two.
Three.
Good.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
10.
And down. Excellent job. We're going to put those on the floor and we're going to come out just a little bit to taking a little bit more of that leg off of the seat, a little more forward in the chair for some lunges. We all know what that is, standing, but a seated lunge is still a bend in this knee. And this upper body is forward, looking down at the floor, the arms are out, fingers spread apart, and then we come back to that position. Open. Bring it back one more time. There, perfect. Slide the foot to the side, it opens the hip. And you look in that same direction, bring it back. So look the way you're sliding your knee. Look, great job. To the front, toes up, the arms are behind you with a nice hamstring stretch. Good, perfect. The other side, lunging forward, bringing some of that weight over your thigh. Good. Three, slide, look, slide it back. Two, three, to the front, toes up, flex that foot, feel that stretch. Good. Two,
three.
Perfect job. All right, back into the chair. Just a little, still have about that much room between your back and the back of the chair. We're gonna take the same position, but turn slightly, having the front chair leg in between those feet that are the same position as we were forward. So the hand that's close to the back holds the frame. Looking forward, extend the back leg. Try to stretch it out from hip to toe. Outside arm, reaching forward, fingertips to shoulder. Grab, the hand is a fist, bring the arm in, round everything, the leg comes in, you're into a little ball. Again, stretch it out, reach, great job. Curl up, nice, Sergio. One more time, stretch it out, curl it up, and sit tall. Nice. Same position, only facing the other way. The feet straddle that front chair leg. Hold on. Reach forward. Nice. Curl into a ball. You're trying to tickle it. Reach and curl up. And one more. Reach and bring it in. Nice job. And we're back to our forward facing position right there. The arms, they're out. Shoulders are relaxed. Hands are relaxed. Flex them. Fingers are spread apart.
Two.
Thank you.
Three.
Four. Five. Make a fist and drop and lift. Two.
Three. Four. Five.
Flex those hands, close and open. Two,
three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Great job, shake them out. So when we do most of these, you want your arms fairly extended so you can see your own. So we're gonna do that right now. Thumbs up, isolating the fingers, out, four, five. One more time, one, two,
three, four, five.
Great job, shake it out. A rotation, soft hands, palms up and down. Good. One up, one down. Flip it, good, both up. The elbows tucked close to the rib cage. The arms to the side, maybe totally out of focus, yeah. Hold and stretch, super, and relax. All right, sit tall, one out, palms up. We're gonna grab the fingers, gently stretching those fingers. Good. And up, pull them back. Good. And then the other hand, one down, and pull them back. Palms facing forward, fingers spread apart. Bend one elbow, placing the hand on your chest. You're gonna look over this hand. So look at this hand, slide this down that sleeve, down that arm, toward the other hand, trying to match your hands up. Pull it out slowly and unfold. Placing it on this chest, looking at this hand, slide it down. Reach for it, good. Pull it out and unfold. Yeah. So we're here. We're gonna close the book. Forearms touch and the hands connect and open and stretch. Close it up. Is it just me or is it hot in here?
It's hot in here.
Thank you. Thought I was having a personal summer. All right, so drop it. And drop it. If you're at home, turn up your air for us, would you please? Great job. Shake it out, stretch it out. We have a couple more. So sitting tall, it's just gonna rest on your head. The chin is level with the floor. Gently pull it to the shoulder. And now to this side. Super, all right, and there. We're gonna do some more toe touches without the weight. So the legs are extended forward, one crossed over the other. Sitting high on those sit bones. So, I mean, sure, we could sit here like this, or worse, we could sit. Pretty comfortable, Jim, actually. But so you want to sit with purpose. You want to sit tall. Lengthen the torso. The arms are extended. The hands are together. Reach forward first. Drop down and try to touch that foot. One. Bring it up. Good.
Two.
Another name for this? Waist management.
Three.
Four. One more.
Five.
And up. Placing the other on top, sitting tall, reaching forward, drop down.
One, two,
good.
Three, four,
and last one.
Five.
Super job, and there. Back into this position, a little deeper, with our feet in a closed position. Hold on to the chair. We are gonna lean back a little. Try not to lean back so much that you're supported by the back. So it's knees up to the chest. It's
one, two, three, four, five.
Keep going.
Six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Great job. Separating the feet, still placing those hands on the chair. The weight shifts to one side a little bit for a bike ride. So it's pedaling forward, two, three, four, five, good,
six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
We won't go back. So change and go to the other side. So
one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Beautiful. And right back in. I don't remind you often enough, but have water. If you're thirsty, have water, all right? We're gonna go and grab this. I didn't plan it, but.
You sure?
No. So sit tall. We're gonna use the ball to warm up our hands and our feet. It's very important because our balance begins at the bottom of our feet, centered in the core. So if you have a moment, you're at home or in class and you can take off your shoes or stocking feet, that's better. So sitting tall, good posture, roll it between your hands. And now stretch the fingers and take the ball and try to work it in between. Remember, we talked about extending the arm forward, so the hand, a fist, soft, and the arm is out. Look over to the side. Good. And then to the ball, and look up, and down, and forward, extending the other arm out, transferring it carefully. Look over the other shoulder. Good. and up and down. Both arms out, hands pretty close to each other. Transfer the ball back and forth. It's okay. Just one moment. Bowling for dollars. Good. Okay, there. Back and forth. Now, be careful. It doesn't matter if you drop it. Close your eyes. Challenge your balance. All right. Open your eyes. The ball placed on the floor. The foot resting softly on the ball. Push down on it. You have a stencil of your sandals. No, but she has cute feet, though. Back and forth. It should be like a very cheap foot massage. Try the other foot. Push down on it and roll back and forth. Stimulate. Do you feel that, Sergio, at all? Yeah? The thicker your, if you don't have stocking feet or bare feet, if you have shoes that are pretty thick-soled, you won't feel it as much. But if you do, it's a good massage. All right, so grab it, please. If you're at home, please put it away. We're gonna squeeze it back into the chair. Grabbing our weights once again, placing them toward the front, out by the knee with an open hand on it. Sitting tall in the chair, that one leg out, trying to place the foot on the floor. Straight leg lift, it's up,
one,
down.
Two. Three,
good,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
get ready,
nine,
flex that foot, toes up,
one, two, three,
good,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine, ten. Comes back to the starting position, the weight shifts, sitting tall in the chair, it's up,
one,
down,
two, three,
four,
five,
six,
seven,
eight,
nine,
ten.
Ten.
Toes,
one,
up, flex a
two,
foot.
Three,
four,
five,
six. Good.
Seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. And it comes back to this position. Lift the first knee and lift it high and hold. Two,
three, four,
five. Touch and lift again.
One,
up,
one,
two,
three,
four, five. Place it down, shift the weight, lift it up.
Two, three, four,
five. And touch one more time.
Up. One, two, three, four, five.
Great job. So we back into a starting position. The weight's underneath your chair and back into the seat. Really? We can do it? Yeah, all the way back in. Using the back for support, bringing your feet behind your knees slightly, engaging those abdominal muscles, pressing against the chair. Arch the back, pull away from it, and then press into it. Good, again, pull away from it, and press. The chin is up, you're looking forward, the legs extend, and the feet are off the floor. Circle, one,
two, three,
four, five, reverse it,
five,
four,
three,
two,
one.
And again, they're here. Pull them back and say goodbye to your chair. Sitting tall, shift the weight, and it's like a rocking motion and a scooting motion forward in that chair toward the edge. The arms are crossed. Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. So arms crossed, maybe the hands are on your shoulders, the feet glued to the floor. Lean back, come very close to touching, but don't. And come up, the arms forward, palms up. Lean back, don't touch. Good job, and up. The arms to the side, open the chest, lean back. Beautiful, and up, arms overhead, lean back. And come up. And then hands now here with a flat back. We transfer that weight forward, looking down at the floor. Lift one heel and then the other one. drop it down. Alternating up, up, down, down. Up, up, down, down. Up, up. Just do heels. Up and down. Up and down. Working your ankles. We are ready for a sit to stand. This is nose over toes. Your feet are wide. Their back slightly behind the knees. The weight is forward. Shift to a standing position all the way up. Good. Bending the knees, placing the weight in the heel, back into the chair. You feel it, and then you want to come. Perfect. And then forward and up. Just one moment. You're welcome. All right. And shifting the weight to the heel, we come back into that chair. If you're at home and you feel, today's just not my day for a balance, put a chair in front of you. Or try this with the counter in front of you or your built-in partner in front of you. Yeah? All right. And all the way up. Good. And back into it. Fingers spread apart, placed on the neck, the elbows while they're stretched to the side. And we're gonna look to one wall, then we're gonna twist and look at the other wall. Keep going. It's a warm up for the real deal. It's a seated crunch. So twist knee to elbow and up,
two,
and up,
three,
and lift,
four,
and up, last one.
Five.
And there we go.
Six.
All right. Go. What we need is the large ball. And we're going to do a little stretching again. So if you're new to watching this on YouTube, the ball, you wondered, it's about 11 inches. Yeah. Forward in the chair, again, with your feet flat on the floor. The ball placed on the chest, the elbows dropped. The arms forward. Your focus is on the top of the ball. Transferring your weight over your thighs. The arms don't drop, but they reach out as far as you can and hold. Good. Come up slowly, the arms overhead, the feet glued to the floor. Lean back and hold. Perfect. And up. Drop it to that starting position. We're going to twist the torso to the side, tracking the ball. Nice. Center to the other side. Work that spine. Good, Bob. Bob one and two. Good. And then on the inner thigh, not on the knee, but on the inside. Hands are on the top. The feet now touch. Bring your feet together. Sitting tall. Squeeze that ball. Good. And relax one more time. Squeeze harder. And relax. Great job. We're going to get out of the chair. We're going to take the ball with us, so separate your feet. Make sure everything we've used so far is on the seat when you stand or directly underneath it. Transfer the weight forward and come up. Don't be in a hurry. No, never be in a hurry. Take your time. Make sure that you have your balance. I'm gonna put the ball on the seat of my chair. We'll be standing to the back about arm's distance away. So if you could tuck that bag underneath your chair. If you look over your chair, you should not see anything unless you put it directly underneath it. So all of these things that we've used so far are out of sight and not going to trip us. So we're going to do some heel lifts with eyes off the floor, lift it up, down, up,
two,
down. So serious.
Three,
four,
five,
six.
Seven,
eight,
nine,
ten. Reverse it. The weight is in the heel. Toes up, down. Try not to stink this out.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Yeah.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten. And shake it out. I'm going to turn just a little bit so that people at home can see about this far away with your feet nice and wide, the weight placed on the ball of the foot, bending forward like you're going to take a bow, your hands resting on the back of the chair. Most of the weight is on the ball of the foot, a flat back. Think of placing your bottle of water on your back. And come up. Good. So transfer most of that weight forward, bend from the hip, take a bow. And come up. Great job. We're going to do some kicks to the back. So, Dawn, don't kick Dave's chair. Make sure that everybody's good. So, kicking to the back, bending the knees, stretching out the quads. Keep your fingers on the chair. The weight is side to side. And
two. And
three.
And
four.
And
five.
Good.
And
six.
And
seven, looking forward.
And
eight.
And
nine.
Smiles are optional.
Ten.
And
all right. To the side of the chair. Yeah. So standing in that same position as we were sitting, feet nice and wide, the weight on the inside leg so that you can place your hand here. Find something to look at. We're going to do some marching or knee lifts. About hip height if you can. So it's up and
two
and
beautiful.
Three.
Eyes off the floor.
Four.
Four.
And
five.
And
six. Good.
And
seven.
And
up.
Eight.
And up.
Nine.
And
ten.
Good job. All right. The ball. Does everyone still have the ball? It's an option, but it's best if you do have it. So standing to the back of the chair with the ball in your hands, we're going to take a side step and then bring that foot together. So you're still to the back of your chair, just to the side. With the outside foot and the hand here on the back of the chair, outside foot takes a split step or a step forward. Good. So think of your natural, your just your regular stride, not huge and not tiny either. So you were here, took a side step and together and a step forward. Yeah, I take big steps. So if you're in the middle, you should be able to lift your heels off the floor. The outside arm holds the ball. And if you're in for the challenge, both hands. Otherwise, please keep that inside hand on the chair, all right? You're in a split step. Outside arm holds the ball. Turn the head and look towards your chair, but over your shoulder. Good. Focus on the ball. Look up slightly. Good. And again, back to the ball. Turn away from the chair. Look over that shoulder, turning just the head. Beautiful. And center. And relax. We're going to go to the other side. We got there by standing to the back of the chair, a side step and together. Good. Outside leg takes a step forward into a split step. Yeah. And the hand on the chair, the outside arm holds the ball, or both. All right. Look towards your chair, turning just the head. Bring the focus back to the ball. Look away from the chair. Good. And look down this time. And forward. Great job. So practice those things in different positions. I would never ask you to do this, that toe heel, but a nice wide split step or just here or maybe even here. the closed position. So we're done with the ball and we're gonna do some cardio. And that's even more important that we look over the chair just to make sure that if you see anything that you brought to class and it's not on the chair, then it needs to be underneath your seat or on the seat itself, not to trip you. And then we're gonna do some cardio. We just wanna stay in motion, keep working it. Exercise. So reach up first and over, flat back, drop it between the feet and raise it overhead. Good.
Two.
Up.
Three.
Up.
Four.
Five.
Up.
Six.
Up.
Seven.
Up.
Eight.
Up.
Nine.
Up.
Ten.
Up.
You want to do it again?
No.
Yeah. All right. On the floor, ready for cool down. Same position that we were when we started. So take a deep breath through the nose. Out through the mouth. All of it. Inhale. Exhale. One more. And out. Drop the chin to the chest and raise. Raise the head. Listen to your shoulder. Center and look up. The jaw relaxes. Center and listen to the other shoulder. Drop the chin to the chest. Remember, sit tall in the chair. Circle the head slowly. Change the direction. Forward and up. Forward and center. And the shoulders roll to the front. Lift them up. Pull them back, pinching the shoulder blades together. Down and circle. In a circle. Reverse that circle. The arms are out. Pull them back and unfold. Hands up and down. I said, turn the doorknob. Somebody said, we have handles. Great. Thank you. Chin to the chest.
There's always
someone. Place the other arm on top. Give yourself a big squeeze. And open. We end the class with a very animated, very vocal, very loud A-E-I-O-U. Go.
A-E-I-O-U.
One more time.
A-E-I-O-U.
Thank you for being here. We'll be back again. Monday, 4th of July, we will not be here. So I wish you a very happy and healthy and safe 4th of July. Thank you.